Hello, survivors, and welcome to episode 23 of 7 Days to Die, modded on the PS4. We are in survival mode. I play in pure survival, but I do share the mod file on this playthrough with my public server, which is also in the details. So if you see anything you like, definitely hit up that server and give it a go. But in this episode here today, we can see the cloud. The sky is cloud free. It is a nice day. There is no fog. We are good to go. So you can actually see now how much work I've done on the face of Cooney Hills here. Wow, has this ever gone wide across. Now that doesn't look like much at all. But if you look down and you see all this area here, I'll show you on the map. That's how much I've dug out already. I spent several hours doing that. It was a lot of work, but it was well worth it. And now today, in today's episode, what we got to do is we got to start hollowing this out and then building in our temporary wall so that the screamers won't bug us. So then I can go ahead and make myself an auger and use the auger and not have to worry about dealing with constant screamer attacks, because augers attract screamers like crazy. So the two things we're going to do today is start working on the bottom of Cooney Hills here. And also what I have to do is I have to go and I have to get my shears and clear out this entire area. I don't want any grass or anything in here. I'm going to have to go and collect also all of these. The shears don't take care of the cacti. So I'm going to need to take care of those as well too manually. Now what I'm going to do, because what I've done on my server, is I've made the ability to actually make military fiber. So if we come in here and we go to our workbench, you can combine 2,000 plant fibers together to make one military fiber, and then you can go ahead and make your military equipment. Now, I didn't make it easy to make your military equipment. For the gloves, you need 10 military fiber, boots, you need 15, helmet, you need 20, we got the leg armor at 20, and military vest at 30. So even if you wish to make military fibers manually, they also take 15 minutes and 21 seconds each to make. So it's still not that easy to make your military fiber, but it does give you an option to not have to farm the zombies and be able just to farm material, right? I love how that horde's over there. I wonder what they're doing. Are they smacking right? Oh, they are. They're smacking right into it. That is going to become a problem, I think. Actually, no. Once we have the build done, it's not going to become a problem. But this wandering horde here, why don't they go around? Why are they digging into it? Is this what they would do? Ugh, stupid wandering horde. You know what, maybe I should go, you know what, I'm going to actually leave them there. We're going to see how much damage they end up doing to the side of the hill. And actually, in all reality, they're helping me out. So dig away, boys, dig away and do my work for me. In the meantime, I don't have any shears on me, but we do have a shitload of materials. Which direction did I put them in? Oh, this thing is so long, I can't remember where I put all my damn chest. Ah, they're over this way, right by where that whole wandering crew of zombies are. Damn it. Okay, I'm going to leave those there. And we are going to go for a quick run to Cactius. That is my main base. It is named after my good buddy Jeff, because he likes to say cacti instead of cactus. So that one's for him. But anyways, let's get on my mini bike here. I also need to make a temporary mini bike place in here, I think. Kind of like the one I have at the other place. Or an emergency shelter, just in case I pull a stupid and end up over here on Horde Night not paying attention to the days. Because it's not like I've never done that before. But yeah, whoops. And happy Tuesday to everybody. And I do wish, I'm not a political person, I don't go over politics on my channel, I can care less who you're voting for, I'm not an American myself, but I do wish all of you the best of luck with your new president, whoever that may be. I don't know what time today it's going to be announced. It may be announced by the time this video is released, maybe not, I'm not entirely sure, but best of luck to you guys, and whatever. Anyways, let's go up into Cactius and get up there. I always fuck up the name. I should rename it something else. It was Castle Cactius, but then I decided to be really cocky with Jeff and go the other way. But whatever, we're not going to do that this time. We need to find our handy pair of shears. Let's see where that went here. Okay, we're looking for, here we are, an empty slot. That's exactly what we were looking for. Awesome. I can actually dump some of this off here while I am here, because I don't need like all this iron. This was I was using upgrade stuff. What else do I need here? This wood. I'm also going to spend some time as well here too, going and collecting a whole bunch of wood. This nail gun I'm leaving on me because I'm going to need that. Obviously, our food and our drink, and we are good to go. Now I do have a bunch of empty glass jars, and I'm going to be getting a bunch of yucca anyways from taking out that cactus. So I'm not going to bring that with me. But it is almost nighttime here, so I'm gonna spend the night, I think. It's not even really much to do up here. I guess I could make some more food and replant my garden if I wanted to. But anyways, I'm gonna spend the night here doing some random stuff up here at our temporary base. Maybe getting the forges going again so we can get more equipment in them. As you can see, these forges are fully loaded. May as well maybe make some more concrete and stuff I need. And get that going, and then spend the morning going over and, you know what, actually screw it. We're gonna head back here real quickly. All right, whatever. I did highlight an episode of these shears with you guys, but I want to show you quickly how these work before I do all that work, because I'm gonna have to go and do this to that whole other area and just get rid of all the ground clutter, because it makes it easier to see the zombies, and it kind of makes it easier when you're laying down frames to plan something out. So you don't have to fight with all the flora in the area, I guess you can call it. But these how these work. Basically, they do one damage per swing. They don't do entity damage, so then they don't make it an efficient weapon. If you're actually going in after anything that have more than one HP, it doesn't do very much damage. Like, look at this wood here. This would take quite a while to do. Now I have had people tell me, oh, you should add a thing to it so that it gets damaged. It's completely impossible, guys. Like, literally, it would get damaged so fast, I'd end up just repairing the whole damn thing the entire time. Thought about it, didn't really work out. So this is how it is. All I did to make the shears, like, let's say you're on the server, to make the shears, come into the menu. They're made in. Oh, they're not made in the crafting table. You can hand make these. I thought I made these in the crafting table, but I guess not. I've added over 550 items into the game, so every once in a while I forget. But it isn't cheap. It does take 25 forged iron and 2 mechanical parts, which isn't super easy to get right off the bat in the early game, so I don't consider it that OP. And all it does really is give you tons of fibers, right? Like, you can mass craft overnight with fibers. Do some fiber stuff. You can make the military fibers, which I'm gonna. That's what I'll do. All the fibers I get out of that area, clearing it all out, I'll start making myself some military gear. What I've been wanting to do for the players is give them an option between grinding out the materials through the enemies or grinding out the materials through the landscape. So it's either up to you. You can mix up both, right? But anyways, I'm gonna cut it out here, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and kill this night off, spend the day shearing out that whole area over there, and then we'll go check too in the morning and see how far those zombies made it into that wall. But anyways, guys, I'm gonna cut it out here, and I'll see you in a few short seconds once I've got some good amount of work done here. Welcome back to a very, very rainy day here in 7 Days to Die, outside of Cooney Hills. Now, as you can see, there is no grass as far as your eye can see. Of course, there is a level where I actually stopped taking the grass out with the shears. It's not rendering in. I'm actually far enough away, and I've sheared the grass far enough away that it doesn't render in on either side when you stand here. So that's pretty cool looking. Ah, we got a thunderstorm. Of course, as soon as I started recording, it started thunderstorming. That's how that works. But over there, we got the flat front of Cooney Hills, and we've got this all done here. Now, a good many people always ask me, Skippy, why do you prefer your landscape to be bush-free? And you know, it kind of looks like it's a young environment, and it needs some time to grow before you start, you know, building on it, I guess you can say. And I'm like, you know what, guys? I can appreciate a lot of bush, but at the same time, that bush, you know, it indicates that the biome has aged. But it also, you know, if you look around, you can't see all the little critters running around in it. You know what I mean? Like, I want to keep an eye out. If there's critters running around out here, I want to get rid of them. Now, even worse, if you get any of that rotting, those rotting ones, well, that's way worse. So you don't want any of that. So by removing all the bush, by trimming Cooney here, what I've done is made it easy to see if there's any trouble coming. And I can get rid of that trouble before that trouble multiplies, if you know what I mean. But yeah, so this took fucking forever to do. I've also gone and gotten a whole ton of wood. It's not all here. I have it in storage too a bit. But I made a buttload of frames. Like a whole buttload of frames. How many did I make? 2,000, I believe. Yeah, about 2,000. Just over 2,000 frames. And that is going to become our wall here along Cooney Hills. To stop the screamers from seeing us. So what I'm going to just do is like build a temporary shelter. Now, I know there is going to be a problem with those zombies walking up and smacking that wood wall. But at least that'll give me some protection for now against any screamers seeing me while I use that auger. There we go. Awesome, look at that, I even leveled up. Nice. Now, I have been avoiding zombies for the most part while doing this. They're just starting to spawn back in again. When we left... Ooh, did I see a glitched out spot? I did, there we go. See that right there? I know it's really hard to see, maybe if we duck underneath it. That there can be a bitch later on when I'm building. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my... That's a little pixel of land left. That qualifies as like a whole block somehow in the coding. So what I'm going to do is barely look at it, put my frame there, and my frame will bust, and that little glitch will be gone. So if you ever see one of those guys, definitely take a second out to get rid of that, because down the road it's going to become big problems. But there we go. So another thing I wanted to do is I have stashed all of the fiber that I've taken out of this area. And believe it or not, it actually may not be as much as you think it is. Oh, look, a chicken. I'm gonna just kill this sucker. Alright, chicken. Give me your goods. Sweat. Now, I know I'm not getting as much with this, but that's not important. I just wanted to kill the chicken because it was there. See what I mean? Now that Cooney's all trim, I can see the chicken. There we go. Tastes like chicken. Awesome. So what I'm going to do is I've stashed them over here in the storage chest. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 full stacks of fibers. It seems like a lot, but that'll only make me 11 military fibers. And that's actually not that many. So let's go ahead here and get our military fibers going. I think that's actually only good enough to build the gloves. I can only make the gloves out of it. So there we go. We got 5 going, and it's also going to take 1 hour and 16 minutes to make 5 of those. So I do believe that balance is actually not that bad. I'm going to use the rest of these here and make some more military fiber. I think I can only make one more because I only have 2,000 left. So here we go. Oh, wait, I can't make that many. I can only make 6 military fiber. Where was my math on that one? Holy crap, Skippy. Give myself a slap here. But there we go. So all of that madness down there, all of that fiber, was only 6 military fibers altogether. So it still is quite the grind to get it. It's not so easy. So what I'm going to do is just keep a temporary storage in here, and all the fibers I have from now on are pretty much going to be turned into plant or military fiber anyways. Now, I did also get 86 aloe vera plants out of that area. To be fair, I did pick a few of them because I ran back and forth in that area quite a bit. And I only got 14 yucca fruit, but that's because, once again, I've picked up all the yucca out of that area. Now, as you can see, I have not done the cactus. I haven't spanked this garbage out. I might get rid of the garbages and these small little things of wood here. So I gotta go along and like do a whole bunch of touch-ups. Those stones can stay there. I don't really care about the stones. But I definitely have to get rid of this stuff. This, I think, to do my time the most efficient use of my time. Because, I mean, I've already put, I think, 3 hours into this episode. I don't even know. So much time has passed. I don't have a timer, so I couldn't tell you. So what I'm going to do when running back and forth building this thing is I'll run through areas I haven't cleared out yet and take out all the little things. Like, I got to go to, and I've only missed a couple of these stones, so... Oh, look at this. I can actually mine these with my axe. It's quick enough now. Nice. That is like early mining right there with your axe. Awesome. So I have to clear all that out, but next project I need to do is I need to start laying down this mammoth of a wall. So basically what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to go, 5 blocks out, and I'm going to build my wall. How high am I going to go here? 1, 2, 3, 4. You know what? I'm going to do this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Ooh, 7 is actually pretty high. I wanted to go 10. And then I can make like a false roof for it, right? Like a ceiling. So it'll be 9 blocks high plus 9, 10. Okay, so that's how much of this mountain I gotta cut out. So I gotta go straight across it and cut it out from there. And then whatever remains on top of that, I'm gonna have to support it all so it doesn't come falling down. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, cool. So that's 10 high there. This wall here, I'm only gonna build this 4 high. This wall's gonna be temporary. It's gonna take a little while to lay out. And I was gonna build a roof to it, but I don't think that's gonna be much of an issue because I don't think the screamers are gonna spawn up there as much as they're gonna spawn down here. But we will find out. And what I'm gonna do is start slapping this this wall together here. This is gonna take quite a while. I have tons of frames. This might even take just as long as it took to get the fibers all up off the ground. So it's gonna plan on a couple hours here. I'm probably gonna hit up the next horde day too while I'm doing this. So I'll most likely, I can't avoid the horde night anymore. Because what you could do at one point in time is you could go for a run off somewhere, wait till horde night comes around, wait till you see your first zombie, then take off and your horde would just gather around over there. And it wouldn't bother you, but if you try running on horde night now, it doesn't matter. Those zombies are going to follow you. If you run to another area, they're going to start spawning in that area. It's not all spawned in at once anymore. It's spawned in stages. So I definitely like that new technique. A big shout out to the Fun Pimps for putting that in. You nerf the way that pussies would play the game. I've been guilty of doing it a couple times. I just didn't feel like dealing with Horde Knights, so I'd run off and have the Hordes spawn in somewhere else and take care of it that way. But yeah, I'm not doing it this time. I guess I am going to have to take on the Horde. That's okay. We're level 107. We should get a few more levels out of the Horde Knight. But once again, guys, I'm going to cut it out here. And when I come back, this wall should be done. And Horde Knight should be over. So I'll see you guys very shortly. Welcome back, survivors. So that wasn't so bad. I was able to get this done in a reasonable amount of time. I just placed the frames down and then went along quickly with my nail. The nail gun is really what made the difference. Now, I did fuck up in some spots where I ended up upgrading it twice because it's so easy to do. Like, even as I walked by there, I press a button by accident and ended up upgrading it. But anyways, here we go. It's morning time. I did save a lot of time this round by actually spending the nighttime outside. I only got 2 or 3 zombies in this time because, like I said, I've cleared out this area. I've kept this area clear. So the spawns are a little bit lower right now. They will reset eventually. But I do have some time in this area because I've kept it clear to do some work at night and only have to take on a few zombies here and there. Okay, awesome. I don't know why I did that. Okay, awesome. So this is a wall here. As you can see, I have upgraded it only once, all the way down. Now, a lot might say this was a waste of wood, but this project is going to be so incredibly big. This wood barrier is actually going to be here for a while. Now, a spot. Now, it won't stop the zombies from spawning up there, and as you can see, falling in here, which is originally why I wanted to do a roof on it. But I'm going to be going so high with the digging anyways that it won't even matter. Well, I've never actually officially had them fall on this side before, so I'm not going to use explosives here. I'm not going to waste my explosive bolts on one zombie. That is actually for Horde Knight. And we still even have time to Horde Knight too, which is pretty damn sick. Yeah, these guys get through this shit pretty fast. They did make zombies do more block damage in this in Alpha 15. So they are a little more tougher, and it is harder to build a base. What you doing there, buddy? Bouncing up and down like crazy? Yeah, you like Cooney too, don't you? But no, I will only be the one bouncing on Cooney, buddy. Yeah, that's right. Learn your place. Okay, I'll take that stuff. So what I'm going to do here is I do have a few frames upgraded. Now, this took slightly over 2 stacks of frames. I fucked up in a few places, lost a few frames, but whatever, right? Whatever. He's stuck in, like, 2 different blocks. Screw you, empty festering cadaver. There we go. He won't be a problem anymore. Okay, so we'll fill that in, and then we'll quickly upgrade the spot because I completely forgot about it. My bad. But I try to be careful because I don't really want to waste wood. Like I said, I am in the desert, but I am fortunate enough to have forest surrounding me. So trees really aren't that much of a problem at all. Whoa, there we go. See? There we go. I upgrade. It's so easy. Like, I have to click once. If I hold my mouse button down, it's just going to upgrade it all. I mean, I can do that, but I'd just be wasting the wood, I think, at that point. Cool. So now we have a fake barrier going up. And by the way, guys, I love how they did the shadows. Look at that. Look how sharp that is. That's fantastic. And that's coming off of that building over there. I know you can't see it because it's right in the sunlight, but there's a pillar right there, like an antenna type thing going on. And that is the shadow you see from here. So just, oh, the little details, they give me shivers. I absolutely love this game, like 100%. Awesome, so we got our wall done here. What else is there to do? Next video, what we're going to do is start digging out the 10 block space underneath this mountain and slowly propping it up. Now, fingers crossed I won't come across too many collapses because this is sandstone. Now, I will show you the one reason why I'm really, really loving sandstone, because I've never really worked with it much before. I've always known it was incredibly weak, but when you collapse other stuff, let's say you're collapsing a mountain made out of stone or a mountain made out of dirt, what happens is you end up having to go back over the collapsed area and digging up all of the dirt and the stone debris. But when you get sandstone, it doesn't do that. Sandstone just breaks down into rock and sand when it falls. So you don't have that second step of going back and having to clear it all up. What I'm doing is actually just trying to get a decent collapse here right now, because there is this little part on the end I forgot to do and I have to finish up. I did do a little bit on that end, but this end here I have to catch up a little more here. Okay, awesome. Whatever. So that's good enough for now. Let's throw a frame on this, see if that'll do it. Maybe throw a few frames? I just want to collapse. There we go. Awesome. So as you can see, there's no piles of debris or no piles of dirt. There is just a bunch of sand and stone kicking around. Not much. It doesn't give you, when you collapse stuff, it doesn't give you nearly the same amount it would if you were to go and hit every one. So basically what you can see is I basically got the equivalent of one space with that many blocks, I guess you can call them. Environment blocks, sandstone blocks. They're all still blocks, right? But I'm really loving this, so I can't wait to make the, once I got this all cleared out, what am I going to do for this? I'll show you guys what I'm going to do for the trick for digging this out to make it quick and easy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go 10 blocks up and fail. Let's get back up here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Awesome. Okay, I'm going to go 10 blocks up and cut out the 10th block all the way across. And then go, I don't know, maybe 5 in, dig, kind of like how I did here, dig it. So it measures 5 in. I'm going to go 5 deep and then 5 in, dig up alongside the wall, dig along the top, and then dig underneath it. And it should collapse only the spot that I'm digging in. So I'm going to try that technique because sandstone is quite weaker and I'm not used to this as a material for caving in. So hopefully that technique works out really well, but oh my god, this even 10 blocks up actually makes this mountain look incredibly small. Let's drop down here and go take a look at how high that 10 blocks up really is, because I'm only at the front of it and I didn't really clip off that much of the mountain, just enough to make it flat. Oh damn, yeah, that's still tons of Cooney Hills on top. Okay, awesome. So it's gonna be a good trick supporting it all, getting it all going. But what we do have time for, ladies and gentlemen, is some time. I'm going to clear out this area here, work on this a little bit more, maybe go do some looting, clear out some of these stones. It's so much easier. I thought I had cleared out all of these stones out of this area, but it turns out they hide in the grass very well. So once I cleared it out, it was a lot easier to see those things. So what I'm going to do maybe is finish up clearing this area out here. It's only day 48, so I don't know how much of the more of this build I can still continue doing. I got to drop off the supplies here. Let's go drop off these supplies. Then what I'm going to do is finish clearing this out. I'm going to wait until day 49. And we'll end off this episode here with doing a little bit of the next horde, which, if my math isn't way off, is day 49. So I will see you guys shortly here in what will be about an hour for me. Actually, an hour and a half. My bad. Anyways, I'll see you guys very shortly here. Oh my god, so I'm barely home for Horde Night here. I am running my ass off. It's gonna get really bad really fast here very soon. So what I did was I accidentally exited the game right before 2200. I was like, okay, well, I'm at the spot I'm gonna record. I'm gonna go take a break. And instead of, pressing skip to pause it, I just left the game, period. Okay, so I need to get up top here. This is gonna get, like, very hectic very fast. But we are back at Cactus. I don't even know whatever the hell I'm calling this base nowadays. So I'm going to put those away. I was out doing some shears, and I had planned on showing you guys a few things. But we got to go and start taking care of business right away here. Now, I do have my normal bolts loaded. So what I'm going to do while they pile up here is get these bolts loaded in. And put a few into these guys, get my skills up a bit. Try to get all these guys into the middle. Stupid cop. They still do a considerable amount of damage to these iron bars, so I have to repair these iron bars every single time I have a friggin' horde. And the nice thing about this, when they grow up like this, the cops actually don't do damage to their buddies, so they don't die as fast. And now, as you can see too, a lot of the embers have been destroyed over time, and I'm just not gonna replace them. It's a cool effect, but as a defensive measure, it really doesn't add that much. And it's it brings your frames per second down just a wee bit. Not a lot, but it does have some sort of effect. Don't blow up, motherfucker. Nice. I don't know why I didn't want him to blow up. It's not like I'm going to not get his materials. But it looks like we have a quiet freaking horde night here. Do we have any enemies up here? Nope, looks like we're okay up here. So, oh Jesus. Okay, you know what? What I'm going to do to encourage the spawning of more zombies is I'm going to kill them faster by loading our explosive bolts. And boom, there we go. All at once. All done. Okay, bring it on, guys. Bring on some more here. Now, I don't have the heat map. Oops. I did not mean to do that. That was instinct. And now, I don't have my heat map going like crazy like I did last time. Last horde, if you guys want to check that out, I believe it's episode 20 or 21. I got the heat map going like crazy, and then I brought in Horde Knight on top of it. So you should have seen it. There was like 50, maybe 50 zombies. It was absolutely insane. It was so much fun. It was a blast, like a complete blast. All right, and it doesn't look like this Horde Knight's actually going to be too rough to me, because maybe it was because I was outside initially. Oh man, did I ever panic when I logged in. I was like, oh no, because what's happened? When you're logging into the game, as I found out by doing this, oh nice, the R lighting on fire coming in here, is that while you're loading in and in that screen where it's like building environment, time passes. It's not supposed to pass. They told us they fixed it, but as I found out, time actually passes because it was right before, I was literally like, 10 minutes before Horde Night in game. And I was like, oh damn, cool. Okay, we're gonna do a super cool Horde Night here. And then I went to escape, go to the washroom, and I exited out of the game like a big old dummy. Well, I'm glad I got in here though. It's not as entertaining for you guys because I didn't die, but it's a lot better for me because I actually have not died in a while. I have my health and stamina back up to a whopping 153. I'll have that back up to 200 in no time. A lot of this construction, a lot of this eating, and a lot of this everything else, it really makes you eat more. The more you use your stamina, the more you have to eat. Okay, this guy's going to just blow up, I think. I'm not going to be able to get to him in time. Ah, yeah, he blew up. And there goes a body. Man, it's a shame. I don't even want to use my explosive bolts on this. There's not enough. I need at least like 10 in here to use an explosive cross bolt. They're so expensive to make. And I saved them too on purpose for Horde Night. Now these guys can actually take a decent beating. Let's aim these a little better, right into their head. Now, this is going to be one of the techniques I use at my main base. This Granted, you know, it's a very, very effective defense, and it worked really well for the Horde Knights and stuff where I wasn't settled and I needed to be protected. But now for me, this is boring, right? All I'm doing is shooting them from above with a crossbow, which is why I'm making my main base. This will be one of the techniques I'll be able to do them. Let's say I want an easy Horde Knight. I'll stand above them. I'll make several different options. Basically, it's going to be a hallway with several different options for several different ways to take on the zombies, which I think is going to be super cool because I've never made a multiple base like that. Usually my bases are just one, like one defensive area and that's it. This base is going to be a hell of different. So for like when I'm doing my forge, I might choose to have the drop chute open so that I really don't have to take them on. But when I want to take them on, I'll close off the drop chute and do a fighting room. There's going to be so many different ways of doing this. I can't wait to do it. Damn, look at that, another level. Freaking leveling is so easy in this game now. Awesome. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is we're going to waste off a few more of these. Whatever. Boom! Did I at least take care of the Feral? Let's see if he gets back up. Yep, nope. He's still alive, and so is that bloated zombie. So eat that Feral zombie. Oh my god, he's still alive. What a tough little motherfucker. Alright, let's blow a arrow into the top of his head here. Oh my god, I can't believe he's still alive. Whatever. Easy XP. Whoa. Wow, how did that miss him? Ouch. I'm glad they can't spit through these iron bars. Now, Alpha 15, the pillars, the half pillars, used to work really well with the cops. It used to stop the spit. But then when the game came out on PS4... that didn't happen so much. I'm like, oh, okay, well, PS4 is just glitchy, right? But now that Alpha 15 is out, it does the exact same thing on Alpha 15. So I know that's an Alpha 15 thing. I think it might be the way they tried to nerf the pillars, the pillar defense. Because, I mean, it didn't make sense that the zombies couldn't spit through it, but you were able to hit them in such a wide space, even with your melee tool, right? Makes a lot of sense. Okay, you know what? See you later. Sayonara, bitches. Oh my goodness. There we go. Finish off the remainder. And he's down for the count. Cool. So this Horde Knight's actually really, really damn slow. That's really unfortunate. I kind of do miss the structured Horde Knights where, you know, you'd get these zombies added and these zombies added. This is kind of nicer, though. I like the wave idea. But I don't know. It's my opinion, not enough at once with the waves. Now you can change that, but I'm probably not going to dick around with that too much. Okay, awesome. Well, guys, that pretty much wraps up this episode here. I know it's probably not a full half an hour. I actually haven't really counted how many time is in between the recordings because I've been more concerned about doing the recordings and how long it is lately. I just kind of do them until I feel that, you know, this is enough material for an episode. But anyways, guys, I'm going to end this here. I'm going to end the Horde Knight, and I will see you in the next episode when we will start digging out Kuni from underneath now that we got her protected. So, as usual, guys, always back up your game saves, especially if you're on console. Stay surviving, keep it classy, and I'll see you in the next episode. Peace out, guys. Wow, there's so many minor zombies in this one. Or construction zombies. Fuck, I don't know. I gotta do a video about those different types of zombies. We're about to turn it on.